Good morning. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're going to get started with worship. Would you stand with us as we sing this song? This actually is a new song for our church, but we had a lot of fun with it last night. They were clapping and just dancing and singing real loud. But this song is called Multiply, and it speaks of God's love finding us wherever we are, and our praise is being multiplied. So let's sing this out. Share some love with you.
apostles, the disciples, those first followers of Jesus after his ascension. And they were completely transformed. And then they turned their world upside down. And this is what we are talking about and celebrating today. What that means for us is that we can be completely transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit in us. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead lives in us. Every time I say that or think about that, it absolutely amazes me and gives me hope for my future, for our future, and for the world. So I hope that you experience just the joy of his presence living in you today and transforming you and giving you hope, whatever your circumstances look like. Welcome, if you're here for the first time. My name is Linda Kiefer. I'm the co-pastor here along with Pastor Dana Antel, and we are very glad that you have joined us. I want to let you know about some things that we have coming up, but first, you can help us by filling out a communication card. You'll find one of those in your bulletin or in the chair in front of you. Looks like this. So if you could take this out right now and fill it out with as much information as you can. And if you even just write your name on here, we will pray for you this week. So we would love to pray for you. So please take the opportunity to fill this out. Any questions you have, anything you'd like to sign up for, go ahead and mark it on here. And you can drop this in the offering basket later on in the service, or in the boxes at the back where it says communication cards. And as I said, it's our joy and our privilege to pray for you, so please at least write your name on there. And did anyone come in the side door over there and see a big googly-eyed thing and on the wall over there? Yeah, anybody see that? Well, I'm not gonna tell you what it's for, but it's a hint of what's coming up this summer, okay? It's there for a reason, I promise. Yeah, and you'll be hearing more about that coming up, and we want to thank, this might give it away, but we want to thank Stacy, our children's ministry director, and Sean for working on that, and you'll be hearing more about that coming up. And Wednesday night services are continuing this Wednesday night. Come out and join us at 6:30, and classes at 7:15. You are welcome to join us anytime. We would love to have you, and we are going deeper with Jesus together, so please come out and take that journey with us. We have our kids camp and youth camp fundraiser is that board at the back that says help bring hope. The word hope is almost there. And we are sending in another week. Actually, we'd like to see all those envelopes come off there. So even if you're not able to give the monetary amount that's on the envelope, if you can give anything at all, just grab one of those envelopes and put your donation in there. And that will be for to send our kids and our youth to camp. We'd like to see that board cleared off today if possible. So if you can help us out, we appreciate that. We have baptism classes today at 11:45. See that? Yes, 11:45. And if you're interested in being baptized next weekend and you want to know more about what it means and what it looks like, come and join me at baptism class at 11:45. And if you aren't able to make it, you still want to be baptized, mark your communication card and we will reach out for you. Next, this coming Saturday, coming up, June the 10th, we're having a women's breakfast, and we are having that every second Saturday of the month, so ladies, you're invited to come out whenever you can. We'd love to have you. We're just going to enjoy some fellowship and some time together. And Party on the Hill on July the 4th. We usually have our hill over here just covered with people watching, going to watch the fireworks. You can see the Dansbury fireworks from here, and so it's a perfect opportunity because they come to us, and so we just want to show our hospitality and welcome them and show them the love of Jesus. We serve free food and just walk around and welcome people and greet them in the name of Jesus. If you can help us with that, we need lots of help, so mark your communication card so we can get a team together to prepare that for our community. We have a new member of our church family. Her name is Sadie. Do we have that picture? There she is. Sadie Crystal Long was born Thursday morning. And Bethany and Jeff Long are her parents. And Pastor Sheree Swink and her husband Doug are the grandparents, if you know them. And so we welcome little Sadie, a little girl, because they've had, I think, three grandsons. And now they have a little granddaughter, so it's beautiful. And I have a special announcement from Kayla. She's going to talk about Bible bowl for just a minute, and would you welcome Kayla?
My name is Kayla. I'm the co-coach of our Bible bowl team, which is Bible quizzing for teens. We've been meeting all year long studying the book of Luke, and then we went a couple times to other churches to go and compete against other teams. And it's just a really great opportunity. We focus a lot on Bible study and looking who Jesus is and what the Gospel of Luke tells us about him. And I wanted to share with you, at the beginning of the year, we asked the kids why the question, who is Jesus, is so important. And, you know, they kind of tried at the beginning of the year, and then we studied all year long, and we asked them again just last week, I think. And one of the answers I got was, how can you understand what the book is saying if you don't know who's saying it? So I thought that was really cool. And then something else we learned was something you learned about Jesus this year, and one of them said he's not just some peace-loving hippie. So I thought that was really cool. We're seeing amazing things with these kids, and their thirst for knowledge and about Jesus and reading the Bible is so cool. Tonight, we are actually taking on pastors and church leaders, so I think Linda's going to be there. We went against them last year, and I think the kids won, so we're doing it again tonight. If anyone wants to come, we're taking over a youth group, and the quiz itself is at 7:30 in the youth room, so feel free to come. And then if you know of any teams you want to join, next year's book is 1st and 2nd Corinthians. So, thank you.
Thank you, Kayla. And Friday night we had our preschool graduation in here, and so that's why all these beautiful decorations are up here. The kids are just amazing, and they're singing their little hearts out, and we thought, well, let's leave the decorations up because we're celebrating our graduates this weekend, and we had a whole bunch of graduates. How many do we have, Becky? 48 preschool graduates on Friday. And that's our preschool director back there, Becky. Everyone away, Becky. Yeah. And then, does a great job. And I'm going to call Jay up here to honor our other graduates.
So do we have anybody that's graduating from anything here today? Any preschool graduates here? No? Any college graduates, high school graduates? All right, anybody know anybody that's graduating this year? There we go, all right. So we have a bunch from our church. This year we're gonna celebrate with them by taking them to Six Flags Great Adventure. I didn't think about the preschool kids, and taking 48 of them to Six Flags might not work, but we'll figure it out. But these are just a few that are gonna pop up here on the screen, and since there's nobody here today, instead of standing up here and praying with them, I'm just gonna pray with you guys, and hopefully we can encourage them to follow the plan that God has laid out for their lives and to continue to just allow His Spirit to work in their lives. So let's pray quick for the graduates. Dear Lord, I thank you for this church and the way that you pour into the youth and the kids and the preschool and everybody, Lord. And I pray that all the lives, that all the kids that are graduating this year, just that they would be encouraged, that we would be examples to them of what it is and what it means to live a godly life, Lord, that we would show them how your transforming power and presence just changes our lives, and that would be something that they would want, Lord. We pray that they would impact the world for you, and that this next journey of their life would just be awesome and amazing. We ask all these things in your name. Amen.
Would you stand with me, join back into worship?
There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. No thing can come close.
like to invite you all to the altar for our time of prayer. We're going to just come and bow before Him in His presence. Put all our cares and concerns on Him. Put it all in His hands, whatever may be going on. We want to just come and give Him praise. That's the time for that, too. We can come and just praise Him for how great He is. He's who He comes to the altar.
Over to you that block us from
from hearing you clearly. Help us to honor others, Lord God. Forgive us for our selfishness. Pray, God, for our community, for our church family, for unity. And I pray, God, that you help us to be bold and loving in your name, God. Pray these things in Jesus' name.